In this illustration, we'll analyze a stationary wave in a doubly clamped rod. Here we are given that a metal rod of length 100 centimeters clamped at two points A and B, as we can see here in the figure, and distance of each clamp from the end of rod is 30 centimeters. And if density and modulus is also given to us, we are required to calculate the minimum and next higher frequency at which stationary waves can be set up in the rod. Now, for this case, we first analyze the ends of the rod which are clamped at one point and other end is open of length 30 centimeter. If this will oscillate, what will be its fundamental frequency? And separately, we calculate the middle section of rod and we find its fundamental frequency and its all harmonics. So, wherever the frequency at which left, right ends as well as middle end will have stationary waves, then only this rod will be oscillating in form of stationary waves. For this, first we calculate the wave speed in rod that can be given as root of y by rho. If we calculate it for longitudinal waves, this is 1.44 into 10 to power 11 divided by 9000. On simplifying, this will give us 4000 meters per second. That is the speed of sound waves in the rod. And if we calculate the fundamental frequency of end sections of rod is, this can be written as NE, which we can write as 2P plus 1 V by 4L, that is odd multiples of any integral value or integer multiplied by V by 4L. And here V by 4L is the fundamental frequency. So, we are writing the fundamental frequency here, we take P is equals to 0. So, for any higher harmonic at which this end section and this end section will have a stationary waves will be given by 2P plus 1V by 4L. Similarly, we can calculate the fundamental frequency of midsection of rod. This can be written as nm and the value can be simply written as v by 2 l2 if this section is taken as l1. Here l1 is 0.3 meter and this section we consider as l2, which is 0.4 meter. So, it must be an integral multiple of v by 2 l for any harmonic at which a stationary waves can set up. So, here we write it qv by 2 l2 with q is equals to 0 for fundamental and l2 is equals to 0.4 meter. And we can write when stationary waves are set up in complete rod, we use NE is equals to NM. And if we equate the two, this will give us here V gets cancelled out. L1, L2 we are already having. On equating these two values, we'll get 2P plus 1 by Q is equals to 3 by 2. On substituting the values of L1, L2 and V gets cancelled out. And as P and Q are integers, here we can write for minimum frequency of oscillations we use here 2p plus 1 should be equals to 3 and q should be equals to 2. If we use this value, then the minimum frequency can be given by directly we can use either of these values. If 2p plus 1 is 3, here it will be used as 3 multiplied by 4000 divided by 4 multiplied by length is 0.3. On simplifying, this is giving us 10,000 hertz, which is one answer for this problem. And if we calculate the next higher frequency Next, our frequency will be 1. When 2p plus 1 is equals to 9 and q is equals to 6, because if we consider it second multiple, 2p plus 1 will become an even integer. That's not possible. So next, odd integer of value of 2p plus 1 once ratio will take place is, for next higher frequency, we can write 2p plus 1 should be equals to 9 and q should be equals to 6, which implies the next frequency at which this will happen is, this will give us 9 times, if we calculate here, if you multiply it by 9, this is 9 times 4000 divided by 4 times 0.3, that gives us 30,000 hertz. That is the next higher frequency at which stationary waves will set up the result of this problem.